So welcome back to my kitchen. Today I'm gonna make some fish soup. There's a difference with fish tea and fish soup. So today I'm gonna make the fish soup, not fish tea, fish soup. Because the difference with fish tea, they don't usually put pumpkin in it. They don't usually use the pumpkin soup. They usually use the fish tea soup, the noodles. But today I'm gonna use the pumpkin noodles mix, the soup mix, and the pumpkin. So this is the difference between the fish tea and the soup. So today I'm gonna make fish soup. Okay, all right, so these are all the ingredients I'm gonna use. These are all the ingredients I choose to use. You could also use yam, you could also use, there's a lot of different things you could use to put in your soup, but these is what I choose to put in my soup. All right, so the first thing is pumpkin. We're gonna cut these up, and we have our pumpkin flavored soup mix, the home style one. We have some all-purpose flour that's gonna make our dumplings. We have some thyme, fresh thyme. Usually I put it to dry, and then it's better if you put it to dry and then use just the leaves only. It's better like that, but ain't got time for that. And we're gonna need some hot Jamaican peppers. We're gonna need some carrots. I thought I had carrots in my fridge. These is all I had, so I'm just gonna use those two. It's whatever right now. I'm gonna use one banana. So in fish tea soup, they usually use banana. They don't usually use banana in soups, like regular soup. But I'm gonna use banana in mine. I like it with a banana. We're gonna need some salt. We're gonna need some chocho. And we're gonna need some potato. I'm just gonna use one because I'm not gonna make a lot of soup. I'm gonna use one corn. And the main ingredients is the fish, and this is my fish. Why my fish look like this is because I fillet my fish. So this is just a regular snapper fish, as you can see, a regular red snapper, as you can see, but I fillet it, like cut it down from the bone, because you can't put the bone in the soup because you don't want to be drinking soup with bones in it, right? So this is the pieces that I'm gonna use, the fillet ones, which is this one is fillet, and this piece is fillet. There's no bones in this one, and I'm just gonna use the head, like at the last. I'm just gonna, like, when I'm almost finished making the soup, I'm gonna put the fish head in the soup just for flavor. That's it. But this part I'm going to throw in the garbage. All right, so the fish head, I'm just gonna put that last. Actually, I'm gonna put all of these in at the same time because the fish doesn't take long to cook and I don't want it to boil out, so you're gonna see the process. All right, so just stay tuned, guys, and let's go. Okay, so I'm gonna show you how to make the dumplings. All right, so for the dumplings, you're just gonna put me the all-purpose flour, put it in a basin like this or something bigger, and you're gonna need some salt and you're gonna need some water. All right, so this is warm water from the pipe. All right, so you just wanna add some salt. Add salt, not a lot, just a little bit. I already
already put some in there, so
I'm not even gonna put any more. Alright, so you just need to mix the salt. And you're gonna pour your water. So, and with that, you're just gonna pour as you go. And pour as you mix. It's not everyone know how to make a dough, dumplings, flour. So I had to realize I had to put this in the video. A lot of people, you'll be surprised, they don't know. And that's okay. You're gonna learn today. Okay, so at this point, while you're making your dough, you're gonna make sure your pot is on the fire, you know, with some water. And make sure it's boiling up, because the first thing we're gonna put in the pot is the dumpling. So my dough is finished. This is how it looks. Everything has come together and it's perfect. All right, so my water is ready for this pot. My water is ready, so I'm just gonna add a little bit of salt to that. That should be good. And then now we're gonna make our dumplings. We're gonna make the dough into dumplings. Alright? Just a preview. I'm making some fried chicken also. If you want a video on this, just on how to make your fried chicken. Just like and comment. Let me know. Alright, and I got you. Okay. So I'm going to show you how to make that dough. Alright, so this is the piece. I just tape off a piece. And then you're just going to slowly make that in your hand. It's like you're making a ball. It's kind of hard, but to do it on camera. But it's basically like you're making a ball. Okay? Like that, and then you just do like this with your palm. Okay? And that's how you make a dumpling. Alright? Put that in the pot, and then we're just gonna repeat that process. All right, take off a piece, and then we're gonna make another one. Keep on repeating this until you finish making your dumplings. And I'm just dropping it in the pot, as you can see, as I go. So I just cut up my corn. It is not easy to cut up, but so at this point I'm gonna put my, after I put my dumpling and my corn in the pot, I'm just gonna put my flavored soup mix. Open it. Like this in here. Alright. Yeah, so this is how my pot looks after putting the dumpling, the corn, and the soup mix flavor. This is how it looks. So what I'm doing right now is cut up my carrots. You don't cut your carrot not too thick and not too thin, because you don't want your carrots to break apart in the pot. I'm gonna cut up my chocho. Oh, and with the chocho, what I do with the chocho, what I did was cut it in half, and I'm just peeling the skin right now, and we're gonna take out this middle piece. Like, it's like the high of the chocho. We don't need to put that in our pot. So I cut up my carrots and my chocho is there. Now I'm gonna cut up my potato. Cut up my potato. I just slice, it's just one potato, so I just slice it in half and make another slice in the middle. It's just four pieces. Now for the pumpkin, we're gonna cut up the pumpkin. So as far as your pumpkin being cut up, you're just gonna need two knives. You need a big one and a small one, all right? And you're gonna see why. So this is where I'm putting my, my skins that I'm going to throw in the garbage. And this is the pumpkin. What you're gonna do is just use a small knife. I mean, if it's comfortable for you to use one knife, that's cool. You could do that. So just use a small knife and just take out the seed spot in the middle right here. All right, and then we're gonna use the same knife. No, you're gonna use the big knife, cut it up smaller. Because the skin is very hard to peel, so this is the whole point of getting the dicing up the pumpkin smaller. So you're gonna use a small knife and peel the skin. It's much easier to peel like this, right? Take off that. There you have it. And this size is perfect. Cut it in two. The size is perfect. Cut this one in three because the chunks is very big. And this size, perfect. I'm just gonna put a little piece more. Middle. Perfect. All right, so we have our pumpkin, we have our potato, chocho, and the carrots. So now, I don't know if we need this piece. This piece. So now we're gonna cut our banana. All Now, when you're doing a fish tea, they don't peel the skin off the banana. They just slice it like this with the skin on. I like the taste of the banana in my fish soup. It is real good. I think you guys should do it with it's optional, but you guys should do it with banana. The taste is really good. And you're just gonna slice it like very small like that, you know, like that. So now we have all our ingredients in this, and we're just gonna put it in the pot. Putting all my ingredients in the pot, and I put my pepper because I want it a little spicy, but I'm not gonna leave the pepper in there for too long because the seeds in it is gonna make the soup very spicy, and I don't want it to be very spicy. So I just put it in there for probably like 2 minutes, and I'm gonna take it out. So I just put my ingredients, the balance of the ingredients in the pot, which is the pumpkin, the chocho, the banana, and what do you call it, potato. Alright, so, and the carrots. So I'm just gonna wait for that to cook. This is what I was telling you about the time. See, all the leaves is off, so now I could take this out. Now I'm just gonna take that out. All right, so I'm gonna take all of them out. There's still more in it. So this is how my soup, see, that's what I'm saying. This is how my soup is looking so far. After I put in all my ingredients, and the fish is not in there yet, so the fish is the last, like the very last, like when all my foods is cooked, like the chocho, the pumpkin, all that, when it's cooked, that's when I'm gonna put the fish, because the fish is like so easy to cook. You just need the fish in there for like 5 minutes. Between 5 to 10 minutes, you just need the fish in there cooking. So you know, fish is easy to cook. So I'm just gonna leave that to cook and come back. Let's put my fish in the pot. Here's my pumpkin is cooked. And the chocho. See, I just put a fish and it's breaking apart already. I have to keep the fish head on the top because I don't want it to break apart in the bottom. But this is how it looks. It's the other fish.